While the town of Dorset clearly trades on the ways and days of long ago, we found one business focused on electrifying the future of, wait for it, Puerto Rico?
Yeah, my name is Bill Laberge. The company's Grassroots Solar, and we design and install solar and storage solutions for people in Vermont and surrounding area.
Yep, that's the business, or at least it was, until it occurred to Bill.
Not everybody can afford to necessarily put up a whole roof full of solar panels like we have behind me, but when the power goes out, they need to run their pellet stove to keep the heat on, or their refrigerator. And so what we've been doing is designing emergency kits for when the power goes out. Instead of a generator, you've got batteries that have stored power and just a couple of solar panels that will recharge it the next day.
The emergency mini solar energy kit concept was initially intended for use in Vermont, but Bill had a customer with Puerto Rican roots. Then Hurricane Maria happened. When the lights went off in Puerto Rico, a light bulb popped on in Bill's head.
Right now, people are suffering. They're having to run generators, costing them $500 a month to put gas in these generators that they can only run 4 or 5 hours a day. And so there's something that's more sustainable, and it's putting up some solar panels and some batteries.
Here's how the mini emergency solar kit works.
We have a solar panel running into our charge controller, and that charges up the battery. And then the inverter takes all that DC power and turns it into AC. So this is plugged into the inverter, so a regular household light, and then you've got your power.
The smallest kit, including tax credits, costs about $1,400. With the kit ready to go, the next thing for Bill was to get his customer to Puerto Rico with it.
This woman's name is Haiti Vasquez Garcia, and we sent her down literally carrying a duffel bag onto the airplane with a charge controller and inverters and some solar panels under her arm. She installed them at her aunt's house. We made it as plug and play as possible. She put it up on the roof, worked with her cousins, and then that night her aunt was able to sleep using her sleep apnea machine for the first time since the hurricane.
The first step is to install the WizBang Junior.
We posted an article about our efforts from Puerto Rico, and it's just been nonstop. I'm getting phone calls from Puerto Rico. I'm getting emails and Facebook messages from Vieques. All these islands need this. I think we're going to be filling a huge need. We're here in Dorset, but this works wherever the sun shines.
Just awesome. And Bill's actually in Puerto Rico right now installing units and training local electricians.
He's got a lot of meetings set up with a lot of people who are very interested, as you can obviously understand. That is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks for joining us. I'm Anthony Everett.
And I'm Shana Seymour. Have a great one, everyone. We'll see you tomorrow night.